U.S. on brink of World War III after Trump responds to North Korea ICBM missile launch. Never since the Cuban Missile Crisis of the early 60s, when John F. Kennedy was president and we were in the middle of the Cold War with the Soviet Union, have we been so close to total global annihilation. U.S. Secretary of Defense James Mattis in a statement earlier today confirmed that the fetus-looking dictator of North Korea, Kim Jong-un, has now fired its highest-ever intercontinental ballistic missile and it poses a dire worldwide threat. Later the Pentagon confirmed that the missile had flown for about 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles, before falling into the Sea of Japan. Never since the Cuban Missile Crisis of the early 60s, when John F. Kennedy was president and we were in the middle of the Cold War with the Soviet Union, have we been so close to total global annihilation. U.S. Secretary of Defense James Mattis in a statement earlier today confirmed that the fetus-looking dictator of North Korea, Kim Jong-un, has now fired its highest-ever intercontinental ballistic missile and it poses a dire worldwide threat. Later the Pentagon confirmed that the missile had flown for about 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles, before falling into the Sea of Japan. The Japanese government released an official statement saying the missile traveled for about 50 minutes but did not actually fly over Japan, as some have done in the past. The White House confirmed that President Donald Trump was briefed while the missile was actually still in the air, to which he afterward said, "We will take care of it." South Korea's military later said it had responded with a missile exercise of its own. This will get ugly. After months of threats and tests, North Korea's despot dictator, Kim Jong-un, flexed his muscles and launched an intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, this morning. The little rocket man likely chuckled to himself, basking in the glow as he envisioned the explosion of what ended up being his target. Now, for the first time since the end of the Cold War, Hawaii has just something that indicates the threat of World War III could be a reality, as other world leaders warn of the same thing. This is North Korea's latest provocation of war that could be their last after two missiles flew directly over Japanese territory, terrifying citizens and sparking a round of worldwide condemnations and sanctions, according to Express. The Japanese government has issued an urgent warning that the final blow could be coming within the next few days. Hawaii has been under direct threat and they aren't taking any chances after seeing that Jong-un is not willing to stop until President Donald Trump personally makes him, which looks like will be sooner, rather than later. Fox News reports. North Korea fired an unidentified ballistic missile in the middle of the night local time Wednesday, a U.S. official confirmed to Fox News. South Korea's Yonhap News Agency, which first reported the launch, said the missile flew eastward from the vicinity of Pyongyang toward the Sea of Japan, according to South Korean military officials. The missile launch happened around 3 a.m. in North Korea. South Korea's military has reportedly staged a precision strike missile exercise in response. Japan's Prime Minister's Office for Disaster and Crisis Management Information tweeted shortly after the report, "North Korea launched a missile that has the possibility of arriving in the exclusive economic zone, EZ, of our country," according to a translation. There have been signs indicating Kim Jong-un's regime was planning a missile launch in recent days. Japan's Kyodo News reported Monday the Japanese government detected radio signals pointing to a possible missile test in the near future. It was only a matter of time before North Korea tried this since Kim Jong-un has been strangely silent for a few months since his last launch in late July. There's no mistaking that what the dictator did was an act of war against Japan, and now it's time for him to pay the price for his actions. Today's launch comes only hours after Hawaii resumed Cold War era nuclear siren tests after getting word of a pending threat from North Korea. According to Reuters, wailing air raid sirens will be sounded for about 60 seconds from more than 400 locations across the central Pacific Islands starting at 11:45 a.m. on Friday, in a test that will be repeated on the first business day of each month thereafter, state officials said. Monthly tests of the nuclear attack siren are being reintroduced in Hawaii in conjunction with public service announcements urging residents of the islands to get inside, stay inside and stay tuned if they should hear the warning. Emergency preparedness is knowing what to expect and what to do for all hazards, Hawaii Emergency Management Agency Chief Vern Miyagi said in one video message posted online. He did not mention North Korea specifically. But the nuclear attack sirens, discontinued since the 1980s,